With depression affecting more than 1 in 10 adults in the United States, how can we help our patients with this daunting mental disorder? Well, here's what the science says. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, an individual may have depression or a major depressive disorder if they suffer from just some of the following signs and symptoms almost every day for a period of at least 2 weeks. The type and severity of symptoms can vary from person to person. There's persistent sadness, anxiety or numbness, feelings of hopelessness, guilt or worthlessness, mood swings, irritability, loss of interest in activities that used to bring pleasure, appetite or changes in weight, restlessness, decreased energy, fatigue, moving or talking more slowly. There could be difficulty sleeping or oversleeping, difficulty concentrating, remembering, or making decisions. And then there's aches or pains or headaches and cramps or digestive problems without a physical cause and not solved with treatment. And finally, there can be suicidal thoughts and suicidal attempts. In addition to major depressive disorder, there are various types of depression differentiated by the symptoms, the severity, and the triggers. I just want to review a few. First, there's persistent depressive disorder, or something called dysthymia. This form of depression is characterized by a depressed mood lasting more than 2 consecutive years, although the severity of those symptoms may vary during this time. Postpartum depression is major depression occurring during pregnancy or following a delivery. There's psychotic depression. Individuals with psychotic depression experience symptoms of severe depression and psychosis, such as delusions or hallucinations. Seasonal affective disorder is a seasonal depression usually occurring during the winter months, with individuals typically experiencing improved moods in the spring and summertime. Premenstrual dysphoric disorder, or PMDD, can occur in women at the beginning of their period. And finally, there's bipolar disorder. While bipolar disorder is not a type of depression, its condition is characterized by experiencing periods of depression and mania, or highs and lows. Now, some form of depressions are linked to specific triggers, such as postpartum depression and seasonal affective disorder. But depression is believed to be caused by a combination of factors. And these can be genetic, biological, environmental, nutritional, or psychological. And risk factors include things like personal history of depression, a family history of depression, trauma or extreme stress, diagnosis with an illness such as diabetes, cancer, Parkinson's disease, or heart disease, use of certain medications, and conventional treatments for depression typically involve antidepressant medications. Other things could involve psychotherapy or modalities such as electroconvulsive therapy. However, there are also a number of evidence-based dietary supplements effective in the treatment of depression. First of all, there's St. John's wort. Several studies have noted the antidepressant effects of St. John's wort. In fact, there was a 2016 systematic review examining the safety and effectiveness of St. John's wort treatment for major depressive disorder. And this found that the effectiveness of St. John's wort was comparable to an antidepressant medication for both mild to moderate depression and had fewer side effects. Remember, when prescribing St. John's wort, it's important to account for any pharmaceuticals your patient may be taking due to the potential drug-nutrient interaction. There's also been some studies on omega fatty acids. There was a meta-analysis conducted in 2011 and also 2014 examining the antidepressant effects of omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acid supplementation, and it found that omega-3 treatment was effective in patients with both diagnosed and undiagnosed depression. And research showed that supplements containing 60% or more of the EPA compared to DHA were effective against primary depression. Another 2012 meta-analysis found that adjunctive treatment with omega-3s improved symptoms of bipolar depression. And then there's exciting research on curcumin. A 2014 randomized double-blind placebo-controlled study compared the use of 500 milligrams twice daily of curcumin or a placebo for 8 weeks in 56 participants with major depressive disorder. And the results demonstrated that curcumin had antidepressant effects with benefits occurring 4 to 8 weeks after treatment. Another study compared the effectiveness of curcumin, fluoxetine, and their combination found that all three groups had comparable effectiveness, indicating that curcumin alone may be an effective and safe treatment for major depressive disorder. Another botanical, saffron. A 6-week double-blind placebo-controlled and randomized trial found that compared to a placebo, Crocus sativus or saffron treatment produced a significantly better outcome on the Hamilton Depression Rating Scale, basically supporting the use of saffron in mild to moderate depression. Another 8-week pilot double-blind randomized trial supporting the antidepressant effects of saffron was similar to fluoxetine treatment in the treatment of mild to moderate depression. And finally, there's SAM-E. Several studies have been conducted which support the use of SAM-E supplementation in the treatment of depression, and that SAM-E may be an effective alternative for serotonin reuptake inhibitor treatment-resistant individuals. For example, there was one double-blind randomized study of 73 serotonin reuptake inhibitor non-responders, and they found that 800 milligrams of adjunctive SAM-E administration twice daily for 6 weeks resulted in greater improvements compared to a placebo. And preliminary evidence also suggests that SAM-E may be a safe and effective alternative to antidepressant medications for individuals with Parkinson's disease. If you have experience with treating patients with depression, by all means, like our post and comment below so we can keep the conversation going. And for more information about depression and a depression protocol, visit FullScript's Practitioner Medical Education Hub at www.fullscript.com/HCP.